I don't understand. Did I wrong you somehow? Did I buy you a James Patterson book for Christmas or something? Or are you just taking pleasure from my suffering?
Netflix's latest holiday series, Dash and Lily, is a romantic adventure through New York City, which follows teens Dash and Lily as they get to know each other through dares passed back and forth in a red notebook. It is based on the young adult series Dash and Lily's Book of Dares by David Levithan and Rachel Cohen. The show consists of 8 episodes and premiered on November 10, 2020. Today, we are going to share with you some behind-the-scenes facts about Dash and Lily. But first, a simple reminder on how to enter our brand new giveaway. We are giving away either an iPhone X Max, the new iPad Mini, or MacBook Pro. It's all your choice. So be sure to leave a like, comment the keyword, subscribe, and turn on notifications to enter the giveaway. It's really that simple. First, we're looking at the famous celebrity who served as an executive producer. Nick Jonas was an executive producer and had a hand in choosing the show's music. He both helped produce Dash and Lily and even made a surprise cameo on the show. According to Joe Trax, the singer-songwriter influenced a lot of the show's music choices. Giving the show a strong musical identity was really important to Nick. His own tastes are diverse and span many different genres, and he encouraged us to think outside the typical holiday box and mix up classic songs with contemporary choices. Getting his opinion and his seal of approval on our music meant a lot. Speaking of Nick Jonas, he was also a part of other aspects of the show. Sean Levy first worked with Nick on the second Night at the Museum movie, and he has always known how creatively hungry and ambitious he is. Sean Levy told The Insider, "When Nick and I decided to team up on this one, I knew that he would pull the weight and be a true collaborator. So unsurprisingly, Nick was very helpful with soundtrack and music suggestions, but he was equally helpful with notes on casting, ideas regarding drafts of the scripts, or edits of episodes. Nick was very hands-on with the shooting of the show. Even though most of the filming was happening when he was on tour around the entire globe and doing a concert every single night." Here is a fact about the show that may surprise a lot of people. Although Dash and Lily was filmed in winter, most of the snow shown on it is fake. It was not very snowy during the time when the show was filmed, so they had to improvise and be creative with their use of fake snow and framing of shots. Sean Levy said, "There were times where if we were even 1 millimeter wider on the lens, you would see that there was not even one single flake of snow on the ground in NYC, he explained. So a lot of that was fakery, but it was essential to pull it off because that romantic NYC holiday time backdrop is a character in itself. Next, we have the way the main stars of the show bond. All of the actors who are in any television show or movie have to bond and get along with each other, don't they? The chemistry between the actors is very important, and Austin Abrams, who plays Dash on Dash and Lily, talked about how he and Midori Francis, who plays Lily, built chemistry even though they were not together on set often, because Dash and Lily don't actually meet in person until the last few episodes. Austin Abrams had the idea to trade notes with Midori Francis in real life to help them build some sort of trust and get to know each other at the same time. In an interview with The Insider, he said, "During filming, we shared our own little notebook of writings, kind of personal things to help develop a sense of trust and get to know each other. We tried to mirror what was happening in the show a little bit. That was helpful in getting to know one another and creating that connection." He hopes that sharing the notebook helped he and Midori's on-screen chemistry. "I think it may have done something. Sometimes you do these things, and what exactly it did isn't necessarily describable, but hopefully there was an energy that transferred. No one will ever know what was written in the pages of that notebook because after they finished filming all 8 episodes of Dash and Lily, Austin burned the pages of the notebook to keep his and Midori's secrets safe. I burned the pages. I still have the notebook, but I burned the pages because it was personal. That was kind of the pact we made." Next is something about the soundtrack to Dash and Lily. In the book, Dash is described as a Decemberist. So when he first enters the Strand at the very beginning of the series, the Decemberists' song, Philomena, is playing. We have mentioned the music, so we have to talk about the real band used in the show. The band who played the Challah Back Boys featured real musicians from New York City. In one of the episodes of Dash and Lily, Lily accepts the dare to go to the Challah Back Boys concert, and that scene features a performance by a real klezmer rock band called Golem, who are based in New York City. The music producer said that Annette Ezekiel Kogan and her band were just delightful to work with, and Tony Maimone produced the tracks as a special bonus. There's a special meaning behind the original placement of the notebook. Dash finds Lily's notebook on a shelf in the Strand behind 2 copies of Franny and Zoe by J.D. Salinger, which is Lily's favorite book. This is also a reference to the Salinger character Holden Caulfield from The Catcher in the Rye, who heavily influenced Dash. Dash and Lily's clothes are from thrift stores. Finding the perfect wardrobes for Dash and Lily was a huge part of their character development, and most of the costumes for Dash and Lily were sourced through vintage kids' shops. Christina Spiridakis, who's the costume designer on the show, said, "Both Dash and Lily are characters who are purposely not mainstream in their behavior, their personalities, and definitely not in their clothing choice. Dash is definitely a person who believes that older is better. His vintage sweaters and other costume pieces were always quality pieces that last and show their age with pride." She also said, "For Lily, she makes her own clothing, so we would scour vintage stores in search of handmade pieces, pieces that had been doctored or changed, and things that were colorful and special and unique, like Lily herself." Some footwear worn by Lily got a lot of attention. Lily's iconic red boots were hand-painted with 6 layers of red paint, and production made 15 pairs of them in total. Wow, that is a lot of hard work for a pair of boots. Lily's Christmas sweater really was handmade. Dash and Lily's costume designer, Christina Spiridakis, made the Christmas tree sweater that Lily wore to the party with Edgar by hand. Here is another fashion fact. In the show, Lily makes her own clothes, including the Christmas tree sweater, and Midori Francis also contributed to Lily's costumes. The Christmas pajamas that Lily wore are from Midori's wardrobe in real life. Now, the filming location. The series was filmed on location in New York City during the fall and winter of 2019. When the showrunner, Joe Trax, started working on the series, he knew that filming in New York City was the only option. In an interview with The Insider, he said, "As much as Dash and Lily are falling in love with each other, in reality, they're not together very much in the show, so they're falling in love with each other by falling in love with New York." The production crew were committed to ensuring the locations were authentic. They had a giant map of the city in the writer's room and put pins on all the locations from the book. Executive producer Sean Levy added, "It was always essential. We never considered filming this anywhere but New York because we didn't want to cheat. We wanted authenticity to the show so that the backdrop of this romantic show could also feel real." There's a familiar face which pops up a few times throughout the show. Michael Cyril Creighton has 2 roles on Dash and Lily. He plays both the elf at Macy's and the drag queen at the Challah Back Boys concert. He also appears at the very end to provide Dash with the key to the Strand. He is seen as the elf at Macy's in Herald Square, where Dash is sent by Lily on an intense dare, which makes him ask Santa for her name. The fictional Pixar movie had a Pixar artist behind it. Katie Wu, who illustrated the poster for the fictional Pixar movie Collation, has actually worked as a Pixar sketch artist in the past. Next, there are several differences between the show and the book. Dash and Lily is based on the novel Dash and Lily's Book of Dares by David Levithan and Rachel Cohn, but many of the dares and subplots in the show are completely different in the book. Unlike the show, the book's ending involves police officers and a giant dog, and the show gives Edgar and Sofia much bigger roles. The original Strand and Dare message did not involve Christmas or singing. The characters Dash and Lily are younger in the book. The book's timeline is a bit more sped up. Lily's caroling group has different members, and in the book, she enjoys baking, but is not shown baking on the show. These are just some of the main differences between the book and the show. The video ends here. Thank you for watching, and please watch our other videos too.